I work as an intensivist in surgical ICU, and I take care of the critically ill patients every day. And one of the biggest challenges for us is always whether we are able to follow and track acuity of the patient status in real time. One of the frustration is that available scores that quantify how sick you are, one of the most commonly used is called SOFA, Sequential Organ Failure Assessment. And it usually works by summarizing 24 hours of the previous day, finding the worst value, and then calculate from that worst value your probability of dying in ICU. Unfortunately, none of the existing scores are commonly and routinely used in ICU. So we developed artificial intelligence tool. So DeepSOFA is artificial intelligence algorithm that uses bedside data and electronic health record data to autonomously calculate probability of dying in real time.
DeepSOFA is one of the first examples of using deep learning technique for capturing a patient clinical trajectory in the ICU. And previous techniques, they were not able to capture the precise trajectory in the ICU. And they are just looking at snapshots of the patient's status at any point. When the doctors are using DeepSOFA in clinical settings, they would be able to see the clinical trajectory of the patients in real time because it works in a continuous manner as the patient's status changes very quickly in the ICU.
So here we have an example of DeepSOFA running for a single patient. This patient was in the ICU for 113 hours. So the bottom half of this example here shows 5 vital signs that are commonly measured in the ICU. DeepSOFA assigns risk levels based on its assessed illness severity. For the patient, we have green, which is low risk, yellow is medium risk, and red is high risk.
You can see that you have almost 60 hours worth of stable vital signs within a normal range, while DeepSOFA is giving you 20% increase in mortality probability. Although this patient looks completely okay, something is wrong with this patient. Something has happened that increased the probability of dying by 20%.
We think that the doctors would be better able to trust the algorithm. This system tells the doctor how it arrived at the decision and not just how it is providing the probability of death. So it does not just provide a number, but it also tells you how it arrived at that number, which is the probability of mortality and predictions for that.